So y'all be back with another video, man, on EB2K20 on my career, episode 32, bruh. Let's get right to it, y'all. It's really good. So, we're going against the Minnesota Timberwolves, y'all. Going against Carl Anthony Towns, Robert, Andrew Wiggins, and Jeff Teague, bruh. You know what I'm saying, bruh? Jeff Teague is about to be taking tough shots. You know what I'm saying, bro. So, let's get right into it. This is EB2K20. On my career, episode 32. You know what I'm saying, bro. This is EB2K20. On my career, episode 32, bro. You know what I'm saying, bro. So, yeah. They go wear green. Green on sand, bro. Yo, I called, but I was gonna sneeze, but I know what I'm saying, but alright, y'all, my next video, after this video, I'm gonna make a car video, so yeah, you know what I'm saying, bruh, after this video, I'm gonna make a car video, y'all, so yeah, this is me to get tuned on my career, episode 32. Y'all, but we going on 13 triple doubles. You know what I'm saying, bro.
Things get ready to roll. Let's.
In 2018, the Minnesota Timberwolves.
All right, David. Thanks. So the next starting five. We've got Jordan, Jay out there with G. Then there's Krebs, and it's smooth in at the point. And for Minnesota, on laying time.
Come on, Jordan, win two.
The tandem at the one and the two, Teague and Culver. And it's Covington in a
we lost the tip. It's all good, though. We're not gonna lose. We winning, bro. We're not losing. We don't take L's. Yo, James. That's a blocking foul. Dang, bro. You blocking people. You blocking, bro. Blocking foul, bro. Don't be doing that, bro. Don't be doing that, bro.
You know, Kevin, it's one of the most fragile elements in team sports. Chemistry.
He dope. He really dope. He really dope, bro. I'm too good, boy.
A work in progress.
And as a leader, as I know you were when you played, I'm sure you were dealing with those things all season long.
Yeah, you try to lead by example, but also there's opportunity in times when you have to step up and voice what you see that could be detrimental to your team's success.
And so it's the Nets getting on the board first. Six on the shot clock.
Look at Carl Anthony Towns. You gotta shoot that, bro. You got to.
That's short off the rim. And here are the Nets. Here's Smooth, and he sends it down right on top of Carl Anthony Towns.
My goodness, that was absolutely
too good.
This building is stunned. He dug deep, Greg, into his bag of tricks there.
Boy, I'd love to get a replay on that one. Let's keep it handy so we can see it again.
So the Timberwolves called their first
time good, boy.
Last season for sure, Greg. A bit of a journey for DeAndre Jordan as he went from the Mavericks to the Knicks before his free agency. Now he is a part of Brooklyn.
And both KD and Kyrie took pay cuts to get Jordan on board. Still a factor with his size and defense, despite a lackluster year in 2019.
He can find
magic and be a force once again.
And the Nets with possession here. Jeff Teague missing from long range.
I tell you what, you better watch out, fellas. He is on fire here today.
And we all know what can happen when he gets rolling, Greg. A hot start can turn into an explosive scoring night.
And
charge.
And it's the Nets taking it the other way.
Oh, you.
My goodness.
You, boy. I'm too good.
Nice play. And you can see they're gathering momentum.
You know, they need to stay aggressive here. Build the lead up while they've got the chance. Don't waste this opportunity.
Now, here's Culver. Throws down the breakaway jam.
Excellent all-around performance so far. Hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
Yes.
Where did that come from?
Oh,
that was beautiful.
What a punch.
Timberwolves have gone 0-4, missing their first four field goals here. Minnesota calls timeout.
Well, it's been an
express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
And, you know, I think he's going to tell them simply, we have to show more fight on the interior. That's the top priority right now.
All right, fans, that was your Timberwolves dancers. Let me hear it.
Here's Vonleh. Pass to Culver.
I'm going for 13 triple doubles. I'm going for it, man. Too good. I'm always going for triple doubles.
Another miss by Minnesota.
Yeah, trying to get going here, but that's an offer for the first five here to start the game. Well, part of their game plan was to block out the noise and just stay focused.
And what's been impressive is that it's not been any one player. It's been a collective effort, contributions from everybody.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Tell you what, forget about easing into the game. They came out with guns blazing.
Another steal. Here's Smooth. And that
360 boy.
Well, 360
boy.
And they show no
360 boy. Too good.
Almost no holes in their performance tonight. They've been tremendous.
Now, here's Teague. Now, Culver releases. Another miss by Minnesota.
And guys, not sure where his head was on that shot. Not what this offense
was designed
to create.
All right. Not at all. I mean, that's where they were looking for a teammate, not trying to do it on his own. He needs to share the wealth there.
And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats.
Let me get that Jeff
Teague. Really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys. And if yes, sir.
That was incredible.
Oh, man.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
And, you know, establishing that physical dominance early gives you a big mental edge, too. Don't discount that.
Teague for three. No. He's off on that one.
And the stroke definitely lacks.
Oh,
are you kidding me?
And this offense is in a...
This is Zaire dunk.
Finding the bottom of the bucket.
He taking the two shots. The cheese out with food. Boy.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, bro, I'm too good.
Oh, that's an old-fashioned rim wrap.
Just a remarkable gem. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now.
Got my tick over, y'all.
Platinum level.
Got my tick over again, y'all. See y'all in the blue team.
That is showtime stuff there.
I think it's my second time. Getting my takeover. I think it's my second time, bro. I'm confused. You know, I always,
not really
his best quarter.
As far as scoring,
let's see.
He can eventually
get back on track.
Oh, this is the kind of start.
It's 30-0.
Yeah, shots. Very good start.
Yo, everybody on this team got they takeover, bro. I got my takeover, Prince.
Well,
about time he got one to fall there. Before that, six straight misses to start this one.
Kicks it to Prince. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just
splash mount physical basketball, guys. Physical basketball.
And George Teague with it. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Just shoot it. You trash, bro. Come on.
That doesn't go in either for
Church.
No other way to put it. Just a rough quarter in terms of scoring. He has not been helping at all.
You know, for a team like the Nets, building without top picks, player development becomes critical. I mean, the Nets have made that a key focus for their franchise, and you can see the results paying dividends now.
Aster Culver. And
the defense, Jordan.
Hey, get that weak stuff out of here. Take it home. James. Jordan is fantastic at rejecting those kinds of shots.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Up their last five baskets, three have been triple.
Clark, you were talking about the Nets player development.
360,
like boy. And Joe Harris are signing as free agents.
Yeah, and you know, guys, a coaching staff dedicated to taking them to the next level in terms of improvement and player development, the investment they make in their top-notch training facility, all of that focus paying off for them.
Prez with the bucket. Prez has got 8 points.
And it's just a great job of controlling that defensive backboard, then getting out in transition. That's been the difference.
7 straight fast break points, Greg. They've got the defense gasping for breath right now.
And I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen tonight. Just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball turning into easy points.
And the foul is...
I guess so then, at 10:25 in the second quarter, bro. Yo, 2K21, bro. It's right around the corner, but not close. It's not close. It's not around the corner.
Durant is out there with Jordan.
It's not just yet.
Then there's Smooth. And it's Irving in at the shooting guard position.
Okay. I like that B right there.
And here's Napier.
That's not, I'm playing, nah. It is not, that's not no B right there, bro. I'm playing, it is a B, though.
And once again off the mark by Minnesota.
I hear that B all the time.
For them on both,
like, when we go against the Timberwolves and some other teams.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one, Greg. They've asserted their will.
Okay, let me get that.
Taking control on the glass.
Let me get that.
Looks like the Timberwolves rolling to
too good.
But
it's their ball. It is their ball, bro. Bro, come on, bro. You gotta pass the ball, bro.
Here's Napier.
Bro, you cannot shoot that right in my face. You can't do that.
And smothered him on that mid-range attempt.
Yo, watch these shoulders. Hold up. Quick isolation.
Making you miserable all night.
Boy. Yeah.
And how about just floating to the rim?
Let me go and slam me down real quick.
He gets up. I mean, he gets up.
Yes, he does. That's what we call helium. Yeast rising and helium floating.
Yo.
Down low, Towns.
Hey, that's a good. Bro, hold up. Bit.
Well, you gotta respect and admire the focus of Towns. I mean, he just doesn't get rattled. He just stays with it, embraces the challenge, and keeps coming.
I want Towns in that paint, bro. I want him in that paint.
Smooth. Napier
coming. Boy.
Already hot coming.
Look at those Towns, boy. Look at those Towns, boy. Too good. Get out of my paint. Get out of my paint.
Let's just say it's a pretty nice run.
Get out of my paint. Carl Anthony Towns. Get out. Get out of my paint, bro.
Over Jordan.
That's some great defense.
No luck. The Nets have gotten 4 of their first 5 shots. Hold up.
Hold up.
Outstanding.
Hold up. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Y'all double teaming, bro. I came with.
Pass to Jay.
Wow.
James outside.
All that, bro.
By Napier.
Wow.
Poked away.
I'll take that right back, though. Sir.
Here's Smooth. Battles through traffic and lays it in.
I'm going to take over again. Y'all knew the double team is coming again, bro.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
And how? I mean, they're taking this defense to task, taking them to school. Every one of their last 10 points have come in the paint.
Clark, if you were a coach on a team, what would you want to see from a guy by the end of his rookie season in the NBA?
You know, Kevin, I won't be specific because I think it's more general in my estimation.
Floppy?
Owning his development. Whatever that means.
Somebody got to get open. Somebody got to get open.
Particular area of the game, yes.
Now, Prince, he open. He open.
The professionalism of work ethic and developing good habits. And really owning that. That's what I would want to see.
Minnesota's gone 0-3 from beyond the
arc to start this. Hold on. Hold.
Napier passes to Towns.
Hey, that's that beat.
Here's the floater. The rebound by the Nets.
All right. I'm gone. I said I'm gone.
That's another miss for him. They're behind in this game largely because he
shot so poorly.
And this offense,
he shot so poorly, right? Yeah, he did.
And you can see
he's shooting so poorly. Look at him. Look at him.
Boy, this is borderline.
He ball hogging, bro. Look at him. He a ball hogger. He is a ball hogger.
Napier kicks to Covington. Back to Napier.
He been a ball hogger. What the heck is you doing? Man, look at that ball. I said, let me get the ball. You can't
even. Five on the clock. Takes a 3.
Whoa. I'm coming right back.
Towns has got 5 points in the quarter.
Towns has remarkable range for a big guy.
I got his ankles. I got Napier ankles. Those shots.
You can just see the passion and love with which he plays the game. You see how he prepares, the work ethic, the way he interacts with his teammates. And when he hits the floor, it's all about the game.
Minnesota calls timeout.
And the young Timberwolves head coach, Ryan Saunders, son of former Minnesota coach Flip Saunders, about as great of a pedigree you could ask for as a young coach.
Well, guys, you've heard me talk about the DNA when it relates to players. It's the same with coaches. I mean, Ryan has grown up seeing his dad coach at a high level, the late Flip Saunders, one of our favorites in the business. He spent his whole life around
that. Stop double teaming.
He has a great way with players
trash.
And a real good understanding of the game to a modern day approach.
Don't care though.
Oh, he is a highlight reel
unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the year, I think.
Without question, a crowd pleaser to the 10th degree.
That's not what I was expecting.
Me either. I don't think anybody was. Even he didn't know what he was going to pull off on that one. Spectacular.
Takes creativity and spontaneity. The ability to make it up on the fly. That's special.
The defense, a press. Here.
And the Nets in transition. Up the court they go. And
2K, bro. Look at 2K.
Feeds to Culver. Shot to stop the run. Good. And it's Napier with the assist.
Right. Jordan.
Napier's got four assists.
Hurry up. Dang, bro. I'm trying to pass the ball to my teammates.
Oh,
I got him again. No, I got to shoot this. I got to shoot that. I got to shoot that.
Knocks down the three ball.
Well, you got to be in awe of what he's doing this quarter.
I broke his ankle, so I got to shoot that, bro. I have to. I got to. Come on, don't let him score on you like that, Jordan.
And he has really come to life here after a slow start in that first quarter.
James with a deep three, and the Nets another three.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooting.
Prez brings the double team.
The defense.
It's going by Prez. And finish off by Prince.
Prince.
Pressuring
the defense,
ball,
boy.
That
too good. We play defense.
You know, you push it after a steal, there's almost no chance the defense can get back.
Yo,
and
my boy Prince got his takeover, bro. Only hitting one of five attempts. They hit him 1 in 5. Yo, whoa. Oh, he said, hold up.
Guarded by Jordan.
You trash, though. You throw, though.
Brooklyn's gotten it going from downtown in the second quarter. They're 3-3.
Bro, are you? Yo, kidding, bro. Oh, my God, bro. Look at 2K. Oh, bro, because 2K be hating.
Towns with the ball. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. Another steal. Here's Smooth. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
Oh, let's go home. That was just
too good,
ridiculous.
Boy.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game.
And guys, it's going to be a long time before we see another one just like that.
Hey, Prince, you got your tickle right? I'm going to give it to you. I'm not see. I told y'all, bro.
5 points in the game.
I said, when somebody got their tickle, I'm going to give it to him.
Stop the run.
I'm gonna give them. I'm gonna give them the ball.
He gets the call and we'll shoot.
And get out of the way, so like always. I'm gonna do that like always.
There, Towns does a great job imitating his usual shot motion.
Hey, Chris, bro, come on.
Minnesota making some changes.
Come on, right here, James. What you doing, boy?
And it's T in for Napier.
Hold on. Come on, get open, Chris.
Here's Smooth.
No, bro. No, we won't.
Smooth passes.
Say what you doing? Okay.
Culver with the
what is you doing, Press? What
on the wing
are you doing?
From 15 feet away, that one wide left.
Press,
here. Brooklyn, they picked up the W against the Rockets in Houston. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for reports.
How many steals I got? I got 13 triple doubles.
Sideline.
Well, Kevin, for the last 5 years, the Golden State Warriors have been the colossus that stood over the NBA. There were thoughts that most teams were not
going
to be
competitive,
knowing that they could not beat the Splash Brothers, Draymond Green, and then Kevin Durant. But the Warriors lost to the Raptors in the finals last year, combined with the injuries to Durant and Klay Thompson, have opened things up. And for the first time in a long time, there are any number of teams in this league that believe it's their time.
Play the defense.
So the West
Come
is
on, don't
no
be fouling, bro.
Interesting matchup what is coming up for sure.
Yo, watch you yourself, though.
The last 2 years, Carl Anthony Towns.
No, my boy James. That's so dope.
You know what, Kevin? I don't think it's as fair as it once was. He's
bro,
not
this
nearly the defensive liability he used to be. He's better
hold
defensively
up.
One
Let
on one. And I think he's
improved
his ability to
hey, y'all,
switch
yo, I think,
and rotate
oh, yeah, yeah,
on
I got my
players.
I got my tick over, so y'all is go double team.
Zhang comes in for Von
Of course. You know what I'm saying? Of course.
That's a nice play. Getting the separation he needs.
For a clean look.
And you look
yeah,
at him, he's
good.
Giving up an awful lot of size in that matchup, so he needs.
Oh, goodness.
Mercy, mercy me.
Yeah.
Oh, here he comes, and there he goes.
Oh, look at him punish that rim.
Boy, the guys on the bench loving every minute of that one.
The pass to Lehman. Passes
so,
yo,
Curry. But not with my takeover. I'm going to wait. My takeover is gone. Fail. Fail.
Six to shoot. Another steal.
Too good. Stop playing with my
and
defense.
In transition, up the court they go. Yep, it counts. 57 points for Smooth.
And where would these guys be without all the easy points off these turnovers?
Boy, it's made matters a lot easier
Stop
for
Stop playing with my defense, bro. Don't play with my defense.
Pass to Towns. Now, here's Teague. Can they get it? Connects from three-point range. Teague's got 5 points so far.
Outstanding vision from Carl Anthony Towns. Not only is he willing to give it up, but he's ready to find his teammates when they're open.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Do you think on average rookies are having a greater impact on their teams now than in decades?
Bro, I'm waiting to my takeover. It's gone.
I think so, Kevin. You can go back and look at the numbers historically.
Every draft class
usually has 6 to 10 rookies that have a significant impact on the respective teams. And of those 10, perhaps 10 or 12, maybe only a few are going to be on playoff teams just because of the nature of the draft. I don't really think that's changed tremendously.
An intentional foul committed, but for what purpose, Greg? I'm not sure.
That is a scene of confusion right there. I can't imagine why.
And so is Brooklyn, holding an unbelievable lead as the quarter wraps up. Defensively, they have gotten after it, contesting every shot going up. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Andrew, they shot the lights out in the first half. What has to change?
Get back. You know, focus on getting back, guarding your man. And I think he's real.
It starts with a man-on-man challenge. Thank you. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow right here on 2K Sports.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. So far, a pretty lopsided game, but still one half to play. I'm Ernie Johnson, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Brooklyn came out looking very confident, looking absolutely unstoppable off the tip. They put together a masterful 12-0 run. They delivered a real beatdown in the first quarter, ending with a whopping lead. Then in quarter number two, it was all hands on deck, and what a show it was. Quality execution, good efficiency, some tremendous defensive play helped them take a decisive advantage, and they're running away with this one. And from what we saw so far from the Nets, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
Well, they went downtown and threw a party. And fortunately, we were all invited. The key is their shooters weren't afraid to pull the trigger on open looks. And it's a blowout right now.
Shaq, what you think about Minnesota?
Well, they were playing like it was Christmas, Ernie. Giving up a lot of turnovers. There's no excuses for the turnover numbers, sloppy ball handling. They looked out of control, and the execution was all over the place.
And that does it for our halftime show. We now take you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third period.
All right.
with the second half upon us. We'll find out if this game becomes the rout that it's threatening to be. What a game we're seeing from Smooth.
Yeah, he's just been raining down on him.
Jeff T.
Dialed in.
Well, you know, the stroke looks fantastic. Even when he's had a hand in his face, it hasn't affected him at all.
Culver and Covington at the two and the three. Farmland Towns, the duo inside. And it's Teague in at the point. That's the group starting the second half for Ryan Saunders. Here's Smooth.
And guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, that's for sure.
Brooklyn Palmer. Yes, indeed. Let's just call him Ladder Climber.
Okay. Jordan, he's checked in for Allen. DeAndre Jordan. On defense, Brooklyn. And that'll be two free throws coming
dang,
up. Officials
bro, you better settle down. That's your fifth L.
Their franchise cornerstone going forward. Cat signed a 5-year deal worth $190 million. And really, it's not even a question.
It's right.
The present
it's
and okay. Future of this team.
But it's making a switch here. Durant's checked in.
And, you know, they're looking good, really good right now because of him. He sees this game by the throat, and he's squeezing hard.
Here's Towns. The kick out to T.
And that's me. Hey, come on,
Towns against
bro. Are you know what I'm saying? The defense, KD. The defense, KD.
Durant isn't just a powerhouse on offense.
But you know, but you're not a center, though.
For when to block shots. Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
Does it as well as anybody, fellas. Tremendous skill while in the air.
Good. Nice play there from Bonley. And with Towns and his extension clutch, it would have been hard to imagine the Timberwolves doing anything different.
You know, I think it's really rare to find a player so complete at this young age as Towns is. I mean, the production he gives you with his scoring and rebounding is really irreplaceable.
And season 4 for Coach Kenny Atkinson with the Nets. You've got to be impressed with the job he's done in Brooklyn.
Yeah, you know, Kenny is a hard worker. He's a bit of a grinder if you were trying to term what category he might fit in. You see that in his team. You know, he admits it. He's getting better just like his players are. And that's a great statement because we're all hopefully getting better as we move forward.
That one falls.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Another steal. Smooth passes to Prez.
You.
Again, the Nets for two.
Defense for me just hasn't made the commitment to smart back in transition, and that's why you see such a huge differential in fast break points.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more.
With the windmill.
Offensively, but at the same time, with the windmill,
boy. With the windmill.
Hey, whatever adjustments they made at halftime, they are working to perfection.
You know, they came out of the locker room, revved up the gas pedal, and haven't slowed down yet.
Hit stolen by Prez. And there's a big
the Jordan Crane slam, boy.
Right over Culver.
Talk about execution.
With the Jordan Crane slam, boy.
Nothing on the table right now.
Yep, they're starting to stretch this lead out. Too much offense to keep pace with.
James against Covington. Lock at six. Towns kicks the team. With some
the cheese. Out with your
boy.
Boy, that expansive reach of Allen. I mean, so good at
positioning the reverse. Windmill, boy. Too good.
To stifle shoot.
With the reverse. Windmill.
This offense
with
is
the reverse. Windmill.
And you can see how they're finishing their plays.
Boy, this is Prince
and Jake that they took over.
Every single attempt finding the bottom of the bucket.
Bro. How many points Jay got? He only got 40.
Teague bounce pass. Outside, Towns. Can they get it? And that's 2 points in the lead. Towns has got 4 points in the quarter.
You know, for a guy with Towns' size, I mean, to have this level of body control, I tell you what, it's no wonder the contact didn't bother the shot.
And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
If it's working, keep working it. That's what I say. Keep the pressure on.
Napier, he's checked in for the Timberwolves.
Dang, converting the three-point play. He is getting the 3 points to officially.
In the last 15 years.
Yeah, and you know, they've had some exciting talent in Minnesota, guys, but they've done very little winning with that talent. I think the good news, though, when you want to spin it positively, they still have that talent, and a lot of the talent is young.
Timberwolves have gone 2 of 6 from the field here in the third. Outside, Towns. He kicks it to Culver. Towns, the fast and eight. That's in for his fifth field goal of the game. Makes him 5 for 12 so far.
You know, defensively, you have to try something different. I mean, Towns has been lighting you up all night.
Drains the three-pointer.
They've been going to him an awful lot this game, and you can see why.
He's pouring it on. Yeah, he is.
Napier,
that's my boy, Drew.
Excellent defense.
That's my boy. That's my boy, Jay.
That is awesome defense. That's my boy, Jay. He's a capable finisher. Well done. I'm sure the coaches love that.
Prayers touching the floor.
Like that have typified
the threes.
Effort today.
The threes in the air.
Ball movement.
Really
the three signs.
The difference in how these
the
teams
three
operate offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
How about the recognition from Culver? Terrific at realizing when the defense
is
broken down.
He dunked them boys. Thinking of Carl Anthony Towns.
That is not possible.
Thinking of Carl Anthony Towns.
I think it is, Greg.
And with the Cowboy celebration. With the Cowboy celebration, boy. Looking on Carl Anthony Towns. Too good, boy.
Can pull
get
something
out
like that
of my paint.
Porky Dangs checked in for Minnesota.
Get out the paint, bro. You trash.
Clark,
I'm looking on you if you in that paint.
If you were entering the league today,
converting the three complete bull, I'm getting the 3 points.
Well, the biggest part would be expanding my shooting range. I was a good shooter at the time that I played, but would need to expand it.
The defense.
Was just starting to stretch out my shooting to the three-point line. And then also defensively, be a little more.
Why don't you pass it? I want my assists.
Really working to get better there.
Drew James,
the ball handling, passing, scoring, rebounding, those were things.
It's all good. It's all good. It's all good. It's all good. You know what I'm saying?
Tipped away. Here's Smooth. And
360, boy.
81 on the night.
I'm too good.
Channeling his inner Mamba right now.
There is no slowing this guy down. He is on fire.
I'm gonna take over again, y'all. See, y'all knew the new team is coming.
And his Napier will bring it up for the Timberwolves. And it's sent back by Allen. And it's out of bounds.
Well, I just said that work. I'll take over. Man, oh my God, bro. I just said that it's the start of the fourth quarter, bro, and I got 81 points, but I could get to 100 points. I could get to I could get the 100 points fast.
Quarter going. You've got friends.
No,
Kyrie Irving is out there with Spencer Dinwiddie, and it's Durant, and it's Smooth in at the two.
Staying alert and aware. Wiggins sees his man flash to an open spot. Passes right on the money.
Haven't we seen that a few times today, guys? I mean, their defense has got to have a little bit more toughness about it.
And if it doesn't, this is only going to get uglier. I mean, that's no way to defend a player.
Nah, bro. I'm a point guard, not no shooting guard, bro.
Teague deciding where to go with it. Pass to Culver.
I'm a point guard, not no shooting guard.
Mark, the two-way contract, a relatively new invention that gives players time in both the G League and the NBA.
I love it, Kevin, because it's another pathway for those aspiring to be NBA players to have a legitimate shot to make their dream come true. The G League is just a notch below the NBA in terms of overall talent. And so I love the fact that players who desire to be pros could have a pathway to get to the NBA by being part of the G League as well.
And these G League players are...
Hold on, man. Bro, Drew. Oh, I thought he got fouled out. DeAndre Jordan got fouled out. Spencer is not no power forward. Bro, I'm sleep. KD is not no center, bro. These matchups are wrong, bro. These matchups are wrong. Oh, no, no. Joe Harris is not no center. I'm tripping. I'm tripping.
Alright. Having an impact, right? Because they're making a difference on a lot of teams.
40% of the players in the league have spent some time in the G League, so it speaks to the impact the G League has on the NBA.
Oh, he missed both.
So for the Nets, Jared Allen's checked in for Durant. Chandler comes in
with the big time jam, boy. With the big time jam, boy.
Dependable passer, Chandler.
The big time jam, boy. The big time jam, boy. Too good.
Fast break. Here they come. Here's Smooth.
The horse swim, boy. The horse swim, boy.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm, and you can see how they're finishing their play.
Boy, this is borderline ridiculous. I mean, every single attempt finding the bottom of the bucket.
He's got it again. Sensational. That's 91, an incredible feat.
This is just flat out insane.
I'm going to take over again, y'all. See y'all new. The new team is coming again, bro.
And following this game, they hit the road to challenge the Bucks in Milwaukee.
Oh. With the reverse. With the reverse.
Oh, nice there. Getting the reverse. Love that. And the fans got a little bit of a show there.
Guys, that one definitely had a little something extra on it.
A jaw-dropper emoji is what I look like right now. Incredible.
Bell passes to Okogie. To end the run.
No, I'm there.
Allen with the
rebound. I just got there.
Allen's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Out to Chandler.
The bro, shooting.
From outside the arc. And the Nets, another three.
Oh, I'm like, are you scared, bro? The celebrities.
I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Certainly. I mean, they saw a weakness in the perimeter defense and took advantage of it.
And again, Brooklyn running the court in transition. And another one falls. Amazing.
And this game has his name written all over it.
Greg, he's been phenomenal, an offensive onslaught. Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. He swipes the ball away again.
Oh, with the horse swim, boy.
Wow.
With the horse swim, boy.
To remember that one for a while.
I know I will, Greg. That was special. That was really special.
A circus dunk for you right there,
defense, guys. Jared Allen.
No luck. Boy, you can just see the frustration.
TP.
Going on. Still, I can't find my town. Mama did something.
You know, guys, no denying it's been a rough patch here. I think they've got to run whatever is best in their playbook to get a good shot.
To the paint, Noel. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
And some much-needed offense right there. He ends that fantastic run by Brooklyn.
Here's Allen. Again, the Nets for two.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
Greg, they keep pulling up and watching them go down. It's a really nice thing to see.
And it's out of bounds. The Nets will take it the other way. Some changes for Brooklyn. Comes in for Wilson. And James subbed in for Torian Prince. Brooklyn in control. Here in the fourth, they've allowed just 4 points. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And this is how you want to come out of the half. Prolific and efficient.
Boy, I like the disposition and attitude since halftime. They're patiently looking for good shots.
Outside, Towns. Towns is doubled. Nabbing another steal.
Just a suffocating defensive performance.
And
my goodness.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play.
That's takeover, y'all.
Well, turning defense to offense. We talk about it all the time. Try to hit your opponent at the other end before they can set up the defense.
Here's Smooth. fans always trying to distract opposing players during free throws.
That's what we need. Sloppy play. Arena?
No, I think it's just a nice workout. Out, guys.
My teammates. Open.
I mean, if a guy misses, it's not because the fans have gone crazy behind the basket. It's because he shot it left or right or short or long. It's
the cheese. That was pretty blue.
At least in my opinion.
Krez with the bucket. And now we'll get perspective here on how the hustle game has been going for the Nets.
We've seen them make the extra effort from a defensive standpoint, closing out airspace and sending shots back.
Another factor here tonight has been the amount of points they've scored off turnover.
He gets it in there.
Bell's
got his first points in this one.
And how about the ferocity of Bell? It's admirable. He crashes the board with such an animalistic nature.
Yo, why you flopping?
My goodness, that was absolutely.
Why you flopping, boy? Car Anthony Towns. Why you
building is
flopping?
He dug deep, Greg, into his bag of tricks.
Don't
there.
Flop.
Boy, I'd love to get a
trying to take a charge. Foul, bird. Nah. It's not going to happen, bird. It's not going to happen.
Pass to Okogie. Launches a three.
Timeout.
And he's
Bird.
Good on the
three. Bird, no. Let me convert that.
Something's brewing,
hold
guys.
On, let me convert that.
Three-pointers just continue to flow.
Yeah, they've had a great second half.
Convert that, boy. I'm going to take over again, yo. See, yo, new, the new team. It's coming again, bro. How many three-pointers I got? I didn't shoot much. I got five. Okay. I got 38 dunks.
Pass to Towns. Clark appeals like we're seeing more and more of this, but celebrations and reactions at both college and pro level.
Yeah, you know what, Kevin? I think it's an outgrowth of the social media for your
life. Yeah, boy.
I think it's a question because anything that can be done that's creative and fun is going to find a life.
Come on, are you kidding, bro?
Guys know that. They're aware. I mean, this generation has grown up with social media. So they understand that they could be seen beyond just the arena if they do something pretty clever.
And you and I are sitting over here watching. We're laughing as much as anybody else, aren't we?
Oh, I'm not denying that it's fun. I love seeing it, actually. But on occasion, it does get a little carried away.
Brooklyn's gotten in the groove from three-point range. They are 4-for-4 since the third quarter ended. Here's Smooth. Shot goes down. Very quick possession right there.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
And you know that's how it goes with him. I mean, his hot streaks, guys, don't last minutes. They last days.
So for the Nets,
my third
James
show.
Checked in for Harris. And Prez is
so good.
In for LeVert.
It's so good. It's Prez all Lundley. Good, bro.
To Okogie.
I got 13 triple doubles.
And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. Chase checked in for Brooklyn. And Minnesota has possession. Shot clock at 6. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. We've seen some ugly incidents last few years, Clark, between players and heckling fans. Can anything be done to fix it?
I think security in the arenas is important. Fans oftentimes they go across
we
the line.
It's me. Oh,
interacting
you know what
with
I'm saying?
Players are usually fueled by alcohol. I don't know how you could control that element of it. The incidents are few and far between. We have seen a few more, but I still don't think it's an epidemic.
Burning a three-point clip, bro. I'm getting
and then
the 3 points to old fashioned, bro. And
really
Jay guys take over, yo.
Educational.
And another steal for him.
And he has been an absolute feast on the floor. Another steal.
Greg, that swipe puts
too
him tied for
yeah.
second all time for most steals in a game. What a defensive effort from him. Minnesota's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Looking to end the run. And a strong finish with two hands.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finish hard with two hands on that stuff.
Yeah, highly efficient. Nothing extra special there. Just effective.
Wow, has he flipped a switch at halftime? Much more effective here in the second half.
Mark, any changes you'd like to see made in the process?
The cheese out with your boy.
Teams are fine for any number of things, incidents on the floor or off the floor.
Well, I think there's a place for fines in the different amounts depending on how egregious the act is by a player or team. Makes some sense, I think, having different categories. But I'm one that would rather hit hard and less often. So I think if you want to minimize the number of finable offenses, then make the penalty be greater for those things that are finable.
Here's a Kobe. Noel gets it to drop, and now he's shooting at a 5-for-8 clip.
Yeah, you know, we've seen a much different version of him in this half, guys. He's been sharper, more focused, and more assertive.
Drops in the tray. James got 16.
Wait, how many points James got? My boy Junior James. He got 9.
15 points here in the second half.
Three-pointers are killing them at this point, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
Yeah, and Greg, you know, the only way that's going to turn around defensively is by stopping the outside shot, not getting into a shootout. They're not going to out-shoot out this team.
Noel, and the rejection by James. Smooth passes to James. Another possession, another assist. Dishing it all over the place in this one.
He's tallying them up in bunches.
Here's a Kobe. Noel.
No, I'm there.
Off target from 3-point range.
Y'all knew the blue team was coming again. Bert and James got
to
take
the
over.
Inside. And another assist for him.
25 assists. What an unselfish performance.
He has been a sensational playmaker. Here's a Kogi. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Clark, take us inside the halftime locker room in the NBA.
Well, players typically just regroup individually. There may be some conversation between the players as a group, but then the coaches will huddle, evaluate what transpired in the first half, what adjustments need to be made, and then they'll communicate that.
He dunked them boys.
And how about just floating to
boys.
The rim on that slam?
Boy, when he gets
good.
Up, I mean, he gets up.
It's too good, boy.
Yes, he does. That's what we call
too good, boy.
He's
too
rising,
good, boy.
And he swipes the ball away again.
Fantastic swipe, and he now stands for himself for second most steals in a game.
Oh, he is so fast. Gets his hands on the ball in the blink of an eye, and Greg, the steal numbers are unreal. It's Bell on the wing, and Smooth is going to pick up the foul. That will get him his fourth foul of the game. Wilson Chandler's checked in for the Nets. Torian Prince comes in for Fred.
Let me know when you call something
for the four, left in the fourth quarter. Bell dishes to Graham. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Just 5 to shoot.
No, no.
Timberwolves again can't hit.
I love the anticipation defensively there to get into the perfect spot. Yes, and with this one winding down,
too good, boys.
Everyone who watched,
stop playing with me, boys. Too good.
A true show of strength for the Nets.
This was a very efficient offense tonight.
And they found a way to get their shots to go down. A little luck didn't hurt. A lot of their 50-50 shots fell their way.
And so checking out their record tonight, Middlemark win number 32 overall.
And playing this team only twice on the year, yet you have to feel good about their strategy and execution. Tonight they complete the season series sweep against the Timberwolves.
And we watched one guy all night long, guys.
We went up against the team two times. Oh, yeah, we did.
Episode 1,
yeah, we did.
What a night tonight it was for Smooth.
Boy, I thought he did a little bit of everything out there tonight, Kevin. I mean, notching the triple-double in style. He was a difference maker.
And you can appreciate the fight now, but
Jordan Curry, slim boy.
Yeah, you know, I agree with
Jordan Curry, slim boy. Too good.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
And you know, this run shows the kind of attitude this team has. I mean, the win is there, go get it.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Really, no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Yeah, but that's no excuse for that kind of foul. I mean, that might be an explanation for it, but certainly doesn't justify it.
Oh! Ew.
Oh!
The whole slam, boy.
They just blocked out the noise, kept on grinding, and this is their reward.
Boy, a fantastic performance. And I tell you something, I mean, you get roadkill, that's always a challenge in the NBA, no matter what. And they got it done.
Here's Smooth. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Noel drains it from beyond.
I'm coming right back.
Jaylen! Noel!
Here's Smooth. It falls.
Well, and this has
241 to 84 is the final score, y'all. All right, let me check these stats, like always. I had 132 points, 4 boards, 25 assists, 28 steals, 4 blocks, 3 turnovers. I had 6 three-pointers. I had 44 dunks. Perez had 32. Jay got a triple-double. KD had 15. James had 14. You know what I'm saying, bro. I had 44 dunks. Perez had 4. Jay had 1. KD had 1. James had 1. Jared Allen had 1 dunk. You know what I'm saying, bro?
How it pans out.
You know what? Teams can get a little 3-happy down the stretch sometimes. Letting it fly.
And so it's Brooklyn easily grabbing this one. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. DeAndre, where did you try to make the...
You know what I'm saying, bro? Jay got a triple-double. 20 points, 13 boards, 10 assists.
Most impact tonight.
We're trying to limit those guys to one shot. They have a really big team, so keeping them off the board. But, you know, setting screens and rolling, putting pressure on those guys. Our guys are shooting the basketball, so it really opened it up for easy looks.
That is how you can impact the game without touching the ball, DeAndre. Thank you. Kevin?
All right, David, thank you. And that about wraps it up. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. We'll see you next time.
Somos pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar.
Our next game, we're going against the Dallas Mavericks. Alright. If y'all like this video, man, like and subscribe. Like and subscribe to the channel. To the channel, bro, turn the post notification bell so you never miss a upload. Go follow me, peace, and go follow me on peace for y'all. Antonio level 2593. And so to my second channel, Antonio Peace. Peace, y'all, love y'all. And I'll see you guys in my next video. It's later, y'all.